So now we're going to take our hypothesis and dump it in and get something out of this. So, step three, we're going to test our hypothesis. And specifically, we're going to test our hypothesis by collecting objective data. There's two different kinds of studies out there when you look at ways to collect objective data about a particular hypothesis. Descriptive studies are going to record data about variables in existing natural systems. So let's say you want to find out who is more susceptible to getting a cold than other people. You would go out and you would ask people about how many hours of sleep they get and what they eat and record whether they got colds or not. That would be a descriptive study. And what you're going to do then is look for relationships. Is there some sort of relationship? People who don't sleep as much get more colds. So you're collecting data and looking for relationships among those pieces of data. An experimental study is when you manipulate systems so that all variables are constant except one. And so this is a much more manipulative system. In this case, if we wanted to find out about colds, maybe you would put everyone in a sleep study and have everyone eat the same foods and have the same activity levels, but have one group get 4 hours of sleep and one group get 8 hours of sleep and see who comes down with a cold or not. So we're keeping most of the variables constant and manipulating just one part. And what this allows you to do in an experimental study is figure out the effect of that one variable. So we know whatever outcome we're seeing on our dependent variable is due to this experimentally manipulated independent variable. So the question is, which of these is better? And maybe in your brain right now you're answering that. So, oh, I think descriptive studies. Oh, I think experimental studies are better. And of course, the answer is it depends. So, over here we have the descriptive study. Descriptive studies are much easier to set up. Experimental studies are much more complex to set up. There's a lot more work making all the variables constant. Because of this, descriptive studies are much cheaper, generally, and experimental studies are going to be much more expensive. Descriptive studies actually describe the real world, so you're going to go out and get information about what's actually happening in a human population with patients or in an ecosystem. Where a lab setting, maybe you're going to see what's happening with rats or with people in very artificial situations. So you're going to get some answers about a variable, but maybe not in real-world situations. The kicker here is that descriptive studies give you correlations, and experimental studies can help establish cause and effect. So, what's the difference between these two? A correlation is when two variables change in some related way. If one variable goes up, the other goes up, or if one variable goes up, the other goes down. This is some relationship. One variable is changing in a way that's related to the other. That doesn't always mean that one is causing the other to change, though. A cause and effect relationship comes from an experimental study, and this is when we know that one variable, in this case an independent variable, is the reason why the other variable is changing. So let's go ahead and look at some examples of the difference between a correlation and a cause and effect. And this video will show you some great examples of that and issues that can come up when we confuse the difference between a correlation and a cause and effect.